And that's all that I'm sure about. Other than that, this is an adventure for all of us. So, can I have the sugar?
What's it all about? This crazy love.
So what do you have to say to the mayors?
I have to say that, Madonna, you have to take out the trash, and Meredith, you have to agree to put the bag back in the trash can because he will never remember.
What do you have to say to the mayors?
The mayors, I want you to know that mayor, as in female, is always right. So don't even try to go there, mayor, as in male. It's only going to be whatever she says. Good luck, you guys.
All right, so what do you guys have to say to the mayors?
Well, we're excited that Madonna and Meredith are making it official, and we're excited to have Radon a part of our family from now on.
All I can say, you know, respect, trust, and just, you know, if somebody makes a mistake, give him another chance. And we are human, we all do, you know, and try to be like, you know, fix it. That's it. Thank you very much.
Just my advice is life is too short and you enjoy every moment of your life.
Travel.
Travel as much as you can and be happy with each other and kiss each other, love each other, hold each other.
See, all right.
Mike and Meredith, I wish you guys happy wedding and happy. Forget about it.
Never just be kind to each other. Never embarrass the other person. And always think about their feelings and communicate. It's a simple deal. Thank you. Tell him some advice.
Do you have any advice for the bride and groom?
Always have something to eat. Look at him. Look at the camera. Always have something to eat. Always have enough money. Always be kind. Never be cruel, and always try to be understanding. And that's what Andrew said, right? Say, hablo español. Hola, say adios. Adios.
Well, the advice that I would give Merdad is to learn four basic words, and these words will enhance your marriage greatly. It's all my fault. Now, if you can master that phrase with a straight face, and maybe a little spit in your eye looking like you were crying, it'll go a long way with my niece. I hope that helps.
You know, the only advice I'd give them is just remember that marriage is not 50-50. You know, some days you got to give 80% while the other one's giving 20. Sometimes you're only going to give 10% and you got to expect them to pick up your slack with 90%. And at the end of the day, don't fight over the little things. You know, everybody bitches and moans about all these little bitty things that really and truly don't affect who they are. Just, you know, enjoy each other and realize it's going to be over, you know, in 50 years, and you can talk about it when you're dead, you know. Don't worry about the little stuff. Let it go.
today to celebrate this thing called love. Woo! Electric word love means forever, and that's a mighty long time, but I'm here to tell you, these two can pull it off.
Woo!
Ron and Marilyn, do I have your blessing to join these two?
Yes.
I'll be in Susan. Do I have your blessing to join these two? Hello, and I want to be the first to welcome everyone here to this great occasion. I know that some of you have traveled a great distance to be here, and on behalf of Ron and Marilyn and the Clinton family and Aubrey and Susan and Murdaugh's family, I want to say thank you, and we really appreciate you being here for this great occasion. For those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Todd Wages, and this is my little sister. I know that everybody here today is wondering how and why I came to be the guy standing up here. And honestly, the second thing you're probably wondering is, why would Meredith give probably the most conservative guy in the room a microphone? In 1994, I met this incredible girl who stole my heart. And then she introduced me to her family, where I met these two little girls who stole it again. But not only did I meet these two incredible little girls, I met a new mom and dad, Ron and Marilyn. And these two girls are as important to me as I have two brothers. They're as important to me as my own two brothers. But I truly believe watching Ron has made me the husband that I am, but most definitely the father that I am. Man, I appreciate you. And I'll never be able to repay you for that. Yeah. And of course, Marilyn has opened my eyes to a world I never knew existed. But I just want to thank both of you for helping develop who I've become. And I truly do love both of you very much. So I just want you to know that. And the great thing is that these are two people Murdaugh gets when he marries Meredith. And so you're a very, very, very blessed guy. But it is fitting that I am the guy standing up here performing this, because on a couple of occasions I've actually had to remove a couple of guys out of her life. So it's only right that I be the one putting the one in your life that's going to be here forever. And so, but since the day I met Meredith, I've busted my butt to be at every single thing that was important to her. If it was important to her, I was going to be there. It's kind of a family thing, but I once stopped at a Whataburger and shaved and changed into a suit just to make sure that I was at some cheerleading thing that was important to her. And so, and let me assure you that there have been many speed records broken so that I was never late. Never been late. And so, but speaking of driving, I was the only one also in the family that was brave enough to get in a car with her and teach her how to drive. But I would also say no one to this day needs to ride with her. But she has come a long way since student driving at 15. But, you know, Meredith, she's infectious to be around. She has the most incredibly adventurous spirit. There's nothing she won't try. There's no place she won't go. She's one of the smartest people you will ever meet. And if you don't believe me, ask her to speak a little Chinese later. Who's Bob? She's a little free-spirited and flows her own tune, which can make Mom crazy at some times. But Meredith is truly a joy to our family and to me. And I cannot wait for her to have a daughter just like her. I met Murdaugh a couple Thanksgivings ago, and my first impression was a guy that was truly and genuinely a nice guy that I thought does not have a damn clue what he is stepping into. And so, but since then I've been able to be around him a lot, and I can say I'm very proud that he finally has stepped up and grabbed the talking stick, because it is very hard to get a word in our family, so he's done a good job of that. But I found him to be extremely considerate, reliable, loyal, intelligent, funny, hardworking, and a guy with genuinely good character. And I would like to say to his parents, as a parent, and especially of two boys, I know how much time, love, and effort you had to put in to make him the guy he is. And so I'm so impressed by what you've accomplished. and I am truly honored to represent the Clinton household in joining our family with yours. So I'm very honored for that. And I do know the kids from this marriage will be blessed with the greatest grandparents ever. So that's awesome. I'm also really impressed with him, with Merdad, and the way he treats Meredith, and the way he really makes her happy. And ultimately, that's what this is all about. It's making the other person happy. Their wants and needs have to come first. Merdad approached me one night at the University of Southern Junction, that's a family book, and asked me how he should go about asking Ron for his blessing to marry Meredith. It made me feel really good that he looked at me as someone that he could ask for advice and come to when he needs somebody to talk to. And I want you to know that for the rest of the time that I'm alive, I hope you still feel like that. The advice I give you will probably not be near as liberal as you want. I will still give it to you. But I told Merdad that he doesn't need to ask for Ron's blessing to marry his daughter. There's only one thing you have to do, and that you have to make him a promise. And that promise is you're going to take care of his daughter. And if you know anything about Ron, it's all he cares about. Take care of his daughters. And so by you standing here today and standing in front of me and these people, this is your promise to him. It's also your promise to me, and it's your promise to On Hill that you're going to take care of her. So, but I'm all choked up because today's really a good day for me. I know everybody's here for Meredith, but this is a great day for me.
Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres.
Do not deceive, do not despise each other anywhere. Do not be angry, nor bear secret resentments. For as a mother will risk her life and watches over her child, so bound must be your love to all, so tender, kind, and mild. Cherish goodwill, right and left, early and late, and without hindrance, without stint. Be free of hate, envy, while standing, walking, and sitting down. Whatever you have in mind, the rule of life is that always best is to be loving and kind. Today you promise to dedicate yourselves completely in each other, with body, speech, and mind. In this life, in every situation, in wealth or poverty, in health or sickness, in happiness or difficulty, you will work together to help each other perfectly. The purpose of your relationship will be to attain enlightenment by perfecting your kindness and compassion toward all sentient beings. Now, please turn together and read aloud the Buddhist wedding prayer.
Today we promise to dedicate ourselves completely to each other with body, speech, and mind. In this life, in every situation, in wealth or poverty, in health or sickness, in happiness or difficulty, we will work to help each other perfectly. The purpose of our relationship will be to attain enlightenment by perfecting our kindness and compassion towards all sentient beings.
It was just yesterday when you and I met at the grocery store, and in a blinking of an eye, we're now saying our vows to one another in front of all the important people in our lives. I, Merdad Bahjeshi, choose you, Meredith Clinton, to be my wife, to respect you in your successes and in your learning failures. You gotta be positive. To care for you in sickness and in health, to nurture you, and to grow with you through the ups and downs of life. We have both been through some downs in our lives.
Hey, I did this, you better
keep going. But I will always appreciate these moments. Can't see these moments as memories, because even in the midst of the hard times, push through. And kept each other up with our positive temperament. feel grateful to share this moment and memory, and share this moment and many others for the rest of our lives with you and our families. And would have wanted it any other way. Not just for this moment, not for an hour, not a day, or a year, I will always love you. An old myth states that man and woman were separated because the gods were frightened of how strong we were together. Men, men and women then were left to search their lives for their halves they lost. You are my other half. Let the gods be afraid. They cannot keep us apart. Thank you for all the sunshine you have shown in my life, and I hope that everyone can have what we have. Let's do this, baby.
Such a happenstance that we only had a 4-minute window of possibility of meeting. 2 minutes too late, and who knows? It still amazes me that you have gone from a boy buying a sandwich at a grocery store to this whole piece of my heart. I know I've told you this story a million times, but I love this story, so I'm gonna repeat it now. When we first started dating, you told me that your older brother was 33, and you were younger than I thought, so I thought I was wasting my time. When you met me, it made me feel like I was suffocating to even try to trust somebody. And then when you brought me a jacket on our third date to the movies because you remembered that I was cold on our second date, something totally changed inside of me. And over the following year, you seemingly effortlessly moved an entire mountain that had warned me never to trust anybody again. And you did this over and over and over again. And not with your words, but with your actions. You did it by just being who you are, this generous and smiling soul. I can no longer imagine my life without you in it. Your smile makes problems melt away, and your unyielding support lets me know that everything is okay. You also like to cuddle a lot. And truly, home is whenever I am with you. But most importantly, I know that we are there for each other, even when things get tough and we have already had a couple of trials. The piece I love most about us is our communication. We always try our best to understand one another and explain ourselves. Even in anger, we are able to communicate that we need to stop communicating. Your patience and kindness seem unending. My family loves you, and even my dog likes you. So I know I'm the luckiest. Usually vows are about loving a person forever and climbing mountains, and they sound a lot like Katy Perry songs sometimes. But here are my two simple vows to you that I find all-encompassing. The first is that we're very lucky to have two parents with very strong and wonderful marriages. Even though they are from different cultures and different backgrounds, they have one thing in common, and that is their sense of humor. They are laughing all the time, and they try their best to make their partner laugh. I promise to keep our marriage humorous and funny, to remember that jobs, business travel, bills, golf shoes, underwear, and even weddings are really trivial issues. I want us to focus on the big picture and laugh on all the comical parts of life and love. I also promise to work together with you as an equal. You are so smart and you have so many great ideas that I couldn't think of alone. You add so much to this relationship, our relationship, and I always want us to work together. So tambourine out, baby.
Comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, in sorrow and in joy, so long as you both shall live.
I do.
And God, will you take Meredith as your wife? Do you pledge to share your life openly with her and speak the truth to her in love? Do you promise to honor and tenderly care for her, to encourage her fulfillment as an individual through all the changes in your lives? Will you comfort her, honor her, keep her in sickness and in health, in sorrow and in joy, as long as you both shall live?
Absolutely, I do.
On it, man. A circle has no beginning or end. It is therefore a symbol of infinity. It is endless, eternal, just the way love should be. The hole in the center of the ring wasn't just considered the space, but rather a gateway or door leading to things and events, both known and unknown. To give a woman a ring signifies never-ending and immortal love. The oldest recorded exchange of wedding rings come from ancient Egypt about 4,800 years ago. The Romans then adopted this tradition, giving rings. The Romans believed that the wedding ring is worn on the left-hand ring finger because there was a thought to be a vein in the finger, referred to as the vena amoris, or the vein of love, said to be directly connected to the heart. Another theory, sounds a little bit more plausible, is that in the early Christian marriages, as the priest recited during the binding, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, he would take the ring and touch the thumb, the index finger, and the middle finger, and then while uttering amen, place the ring on the third finger, which then sealed the marriage. Meredith, repeat after me. Merdad, with this ring, I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
That from this day forward, you will not walk alone. Merdad, repeat after me. Meredith, with this ring.
Meredith, with this ring.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
That from this day forward, you will not walk alone.
You will not walk alone.
And now, my favorite part. With the Church of Universal Life Powers vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Thank you.